Are you from a country where proof of English language fluency is a prerequisite before sitting PLAB? Then you must have been torn choosing between which exam to take, IELTS or OET. Fear not, because we are here to guide you. As international medical graduates planning to work in the UK, you will be tested on how well you can communicate using the English language. This will be a requirement for sitting PLAB, GMC registration, and applying for UK work visa. Essentially, what this video will tell you are the general similarities, differences, and probably the advantage of one exam over the other. But it all boils down to how well you will prepare for either exam. As mentioned in my previous videos, either English exams should not be taken lightly, as it can affect your timeline towards becoming GMC registered physicians. Now let's get started. IELTS stands for International English Language Testing System, while OET means Occupational English Test. Both exams will assess your knowledge of the English language that is accepted internationally. Both consists of four subsets: listening, reading, writing, and speaking. For both tests, there will be a specific cutoff scores, and we'll get into that later. At this point, it is important to know that there are various IELTS exams, but as a doctor, you would be required to take the IELTS Academic UKVI. Now, moving on to their differences. IELTS Academic is designed for everyone, regardless of profession. For this reason, the tasks can be about anything you can think of. Let's discuss each subtest. The listening part will last for approximately 30 minutes, where you will listen to four different recordings of native English speakers, then write your answers to a list of questions. The reading section will last for 60 minutes, consisting of 40 questions, where there are three long texts taken from books, journals, magazines, and newspapers. It aims to assess a wide range of reading skills, including gist, skimming, or understanding an argument, among others. Academic writing has two tasks that should be completed within 60 minutes. In the first part, you are tasked to describe, summarize, or explain a graph, table, or diagram presented to you. The second part, on the other hand, will require you to write an essay in response to a view, an argument, or a problem. Lastly, the speaking subtest has three parts, lasting 11 to 14 minutes in total. In part 1, the examiner will ask general questions about yourself, home, family, work, and/or interests. Meanwhile, in part 2, a card will be handed to you and you will have to elaborate on what topic is written. Finally, the last part will revolve around follow-up questions about part 2. Your examiner will be the one to give your corresponding grade. In contrast, OET is targeted towards healthcare professionals, hence the exam structure puts emphasis on communication in a healthcare environment. The listening subtest is comprised of three parts and lasts for approximately 45 minutes, where you are tasked to follow and understand a range of health-related materials, such as consultations and lectures. The reading part is likewise subdivided into three tasks, lasting for 60 minutes in total. Part A involves an expeditious reading task, which you will have to complete in 15 minutes. On the contrary, parts B and C will assess your ability to identify the main point of 8 texts from extracts in various healthcare workplaces. Both listening and reading parts have a total of 42 questions each, with the same content across all professions. Your task in the writing part is either to write a discharge, referral, or transfer letter. You will be given 45 minutes to complete this task. Lastly, the speaking subtest is divided into two recorded role plays. An interlocutor will play the role of the patient or a relative, while you take your professional role. Each role play will last for 5 minutes plus 3 minutes of preparation. You will be given scenarios and a card based on typical workplace situations. The audio recording will then be sent for assessment. Hence, the interlocutor will not be grading your performance right there and then. Both writing and speaking will be specific to your profession. For IELTS Academic, an overall score of 7.5 and a minimum of 7.0 in all sections is accepted for PLAB, GMC registration, UK work visa, and non-training jobs. For OET, a minimum score of 350 or grade B across all sections is required for PLAB, GMC registration, UK work visa, and non-training jobs. Be aware that the English requirements for UK Foundation Program and Standalone FY2 are higher and you should have an IELTS score of 7.5 in all sections or an OET score of 400 in all sections. IELTS Academic UKVI will cost you around 12,000 pesos. And the fee for OET is about 23,000 pesos. For IELTS, the results will be released after 13 working days if paper-based exam, while 3 to 5 days after computer-delivered test. For OET, the results are out after 16 business days. Both exams will be valid for 2 years. There are multiple learning resources and mock exams available online. In addition, there are loads of preparation courses offered by various institutions. You may also find some YouTube channels helpful.